Today, we're talking about chronic fatigue syndrome. It has an unknown cause, and the name for that is idiopathic. It is worse with exercise, and the people who suffer from it have poor sleep, and sleeping does not improve the situation. They are constantly exhausted, and there's no test that will pick this up now. Despite drinking massive amounts of coffee, you could not wake up. You will be in a constant fog trying to search out something that could help you. So, what are the big symptoms of chronic fatigue syndrome? You guessed it, chronic fatigue, but there are some other ones that will give us the clue to uncovering what's really behind this problem. So we also have memory loss, sore throat, enlarged glands, joint pain, headaches. You're unresponsive to sleep. You sleep, but there's no change with your energy. And extreme exhaustion. One of the biggest causes of chronic fatigue syndrome is a hidden virus. Okay, what you need to know about viruses is this. A virus is not really alive. It's a piece of genetic material, wrapped in a little sac that gets activated by your own cells. What happens when your immune system overcomes the viruses and deactivates them? They can lie dormant for years, and they can also come out of remission and be active. That's called the latent virus. The most common virus behind chronic fatigue syndrome is the Epstein-Barr virus. 90% of the population worldwide have Epstein-Barr virus. It's very, very common. It is bad to the point where you could barely even swallow. So, what happens? If you have this infection and it goes in remission, you will do fine for many years, then you accumulate a lot of stress and maybe you have nutritional deficiencies, and then the virus comes out of remission. So, what makes this virus come out remission? Primarily is stress. It could be a loss of a loved one or stress at work or whatever, and the virus starts coming out of remission. If you combine stress with nutritional deficiencies, the virus can come out, and actually create extreme exhaustion. Also, Epstein virus is one of the causes of Hashimoto's, which is an autoimmune hypothyroidism. Selenium is very, very important in this situation. Also, you need high doses of vitamin D, 20,000 international units. Vitamin D is one of the most potent nutrients to help put a virus back in remission. Zinc is number two. You want to take 30 milligrams of zinc and also folic acid. That's a really good one as well. You can get this over the counter in the store. Also, don't forget about the stress. You must do everything you can to improve this stress state because, unless the stress is improved, it's very difficult to send this virus back into remission. The second thing that will cause chronic fatigue syndrome is insulin resistance. What is insulin resistance? Well, insulin is a hormone that does a lot of things. But one of the things that will do, it will act as a key to open up the cell to allow fuel and nutrients to go into the cell. So, if you have a lot of insulin being pumped out in your body over a long period of time, that could be toxic. So the body is going to resist that and you're going to create this condition called insulin resistance. At least 65 to 70% of the population has this and they don't usually even know it. One of the big things that will create is belly fat. So, if you look down and you can see your belly, that means you have insulin resistance. If you can't go for more than 3 or 4 hours without needing a snack or food, you have insulin resistance. If you crave sweets, you have insulin resistance. If you eat a meal and you're not satisfied, and you need a little bit of sweet after that, you have insulin resistance. If you're getting up through the night and having to urinate, that means you have insulin resistance. Insulin also lowers blood sugars, so it is related to blood sugars and consuming too many carbohydrates. So, if you've been on a high-carb diet like most of the population, that's really what's behind this. So, the relationship between insulin resistance and fatigue is that your cells are starving of fuel, especially the brain and even the muscles. They're going to be tired. And you're not going to have the mental energy and you will suffer from a lack of focus. One really good simple test you could do with yourself is just consume a protein meal with some vegetables, no sugar, no extra carbohydrates and see how you feel. If this fatigue goes away, then it's most likely that you have this condition. It's a very simple to correct. If you actually do healthy keto and intermittent fasting, exercise and following low-carb diet. Now, you know the two main causes of chronic fatigue syndrome, which if you really understand this, and you apply what we are showing you, it's pretty straightforward to resolve this condition. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, offer it a thumbs up, and share it with your friends. For more nutrients and tips, subscribe to the channel and click that little bell icon.